Assalamualaikum, dear brothers and sisters. We are broadcasting live from Channel A9 and Harun Yahya Studios. We are together with Sister Begum, Sister Gulen, and I'm Dolunay. Tonight we will talk about science leading to faith topics, misconceptions of evolution. And first of all, we would like to start with a very important molecule, glucose.
Yes. It is actually vitally important for our body because the glucose is a basic source of food for all living beings. And by means of this molecule, we can move our arms, work our even jaw muscles while we are eating food or while we are walking. And glucose has 6 carbon, 12 hydrogen and 6 oxygen atoms. Mm-hmm. And for example, because of these hydrogen atoms, this glucose molecule has a hexagonal shape. And also 6 oxygen molecules give glucose many vitally properties, and by means of oxygen molecules, glucose can easily dissolve in the water. And because by means of this again oxygen molecule, this molecule can form a very strong bond with the hydrogen bonds with water molecules. And as a reason, glucose can dissolve in any kind of fluid. And this property is vitally important for us. And why we can think about this? Because it is the most important nutrient source for our cells in our body. And only by the transportation of blood, they can, this glucose can reach to the cells. And just because of this, of course, it is really very important for this molecule to dissolve in water. Mm-hmm. And we can think about the importance of the dissolution of this molecule with another example. For example, there is another molecule named hexane, and this molecule has a lot of common properties with this glucose molecule and is very similar to glucose, especially as a fuel. But hexane doesn't carry any oxygen molecules. And just because of this, when it burns, it causes many new and strong carbon-oxygen bonds. And this property of the hexane prevents this molecule from dissolving in the water. And most importantly, hexane cannot carry it to the cells by the blood. So normally, glucose is less efficient than this other molecule. But actually, just because of it can dissolve in water, it is of course vitally important for us than this hexane molecule. And when this molecule, glucose, enter to any solution, it can turn its energy into fuel. For example, and just because of this, glucose is the basic energy source of all the living beings. There are bigger molecules, and these bigger molecules, like complex sugars, like starch, they are scaled down in the form of glucose, and in order to be easily burned and reach to the cells, taken to the cells. Mm-hmm. And in this way, the glucose takes names such, for example, we know that, I'm sure you have heard, like the grape sugar.
Yes.
Like blood sugar or starch sugar, and this depending on the metabolism, it enters this glucose molecule. Mm-hmm. And another important point is how glucose molecules that emerge during the digestion process are balanced. And we know that carbohydrates are very important for us. And for example, the 70% of the blood we eat supplies carbohydrate for us. And the digestion of the carbohydrates begins in the mouth. And in this process, in the mouth, there are other enzymes. For example, these enzymes break down carbohydrates inside the saliva. Mm-hmm. And the digestion of the carbohydrates, which are broken down, partially ends in the small intestine. And the glucose molecule, which comes out as a result of this process, increase the blood pressure. But blood pressure is, at this point, balanced with another enzyme. And this interfere with glucose molecule. And in short, a very important molecule, in the body is balanced with another enzyme. And what happens in the case of, we can think, in the case of increasing of the glucose in our body, in this case, the excess glucose molecules are stored after being turned into another shape called glycogen with help of an enzyme. And this enzyme is named glycokinase. And this enzyme is produced by the liver, and also this production is under the control of the insulin hormone. And the glycogen steps in, and when there is energy need in the body, and also it becomes ready to use. And in fact, we can think that, for example, it is really very, there is a process here. For example, we are eating bread, and this bread starts to process, this it's a carbohydrate, and this carbohydrate starts to dissolve in the with the enzymes. This enzyme is breaking down this carbohydrate, and at the end, in this this process ends in the small intestine, and there the glucose is dissolved, and right in this process, after glucose level is increased, then this glucokinase starts to use makes this glucose, turns it into the glycogen, and then there is in the liver there is another hormone, and this hormone is insulin. And there is a lot of process, there is a lot of important facts, and they yes, and they have to work all together.
MashaAllah, yes. And you are talking about glucose is something that our body cannot produce.
Yes.
It is coming from outside. But our body has a strategy to use this glucose.
Yes.
This is something very amazing. And all the body parts are made up of cells, as you know. All the cells are alone. And all these cells, as one by one, know what to do. For example, the ones in the mouth know that they will have to produce some kind of enzymes. The glands, the places, everything in the mouth should be ready for this glucose. But this glucose is not coming outside as a glucose. It is coming outside from outside as a bread, or as a carbohydrate, or as a potatoes, or something like that. But our mouth knows that.
Recognizes
it and knows that we need glucose in the blood. So all the body has this strategy. It is impossible for all these things to happen by chance. It is obvious. Whenever you think about it, why should a body get ready for something coming from outside to make it dissolve, to make it break down, and to make it and then store, and then calculate its amount in the blood all the time? Because sugar amount in the blood is very important. Yes. If it increases, it may cause very serious diseases, even blindness. And diabetes, everybody knows it. And but everything in the body has an intent to control it, and also need it all the time, want it, and try to use it, but always control it, under control. There are special hormones,
yes,
as you said, sister, and they are the insulin. If it is increases, if it is decreases, glucagon, if it is happening, there is a special organ called pancreas, and there are special cells. They are specialized. They didn't do any master's degree, or they didn't go to university, but they can produce such kind of hormones perfectly without any mistake. If any mistake happens, everybody knows there are several types of diabetes.
Yes.
And these are very serious diseases that people have to use injections and take these hormones from outside to control and make the balance of these hormones.
Yes.
All the components are like engineers in a factory who are working like chemists.
Yes.
Even though they are blind, unconscious.
And not even the chemist is enough. You have to there have to be other specialists who deal this production, who control, check them, who transport them to the point that it is needed.
Yes.
There is a lot of processes, but even in the factories, this process is, most of the time it is under the control, but they cannot prevent to make mistakes because it is the human-made things, and we know that there's a lot of, there are a lot of problems and occurs in these processes. But in our body, never these kinds of other than some diseases, but normally in a healthy person, it is always works in the way that it is needed, mashallah.
This is also is necessary to understand how a healthy human being would be.
Yes.
If there wouldn't be any disease, how could we understand how the perfect is creation of Allah?
Yes, all the time actually. We, the scientists, understand what is a protein, what is a hormone, what is the system that is working because of diseases.
They compare
always. They compare the healthy ones with the diseased one, and then they understand that, yes, there is something wrong in here, so it means that there is something that should be here or that shouldn't be here, and then they start to understand. But for a healthy person, maybe he or she has never ever thought about the insulin hormone amount in his blood or in her blood, but the cells in her blood or his blood, they're always taking care of it. It is very important for them.
And even only this example is enough to show that actually evolution cannot happen.
Yes.
It is not, we cannot evolve stage by stage like they are claiming. Because if there is not insulin, there is not glycogen, there is not glucose, and this the this level of sugar will increase and it will cause death. And this history of mankind cannot be like this today. But we see that Allah created them with the order B. Allah says that I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. He said B and it is, inshallah. And this is the order of Allah. Everything happens in the process that Allah says and it is. And in other words, Allah says that I seek refuge in Allah from a cursed Satan. We created man from the purest kind of clay, then made him a drop in a secure receptacle. Then formed the drop into a clot, and formed the clot into a lump, and formed the lump into bones, and clothed the bones in flesh, and then brought him into being as another creature. Blessed be Allah, the best of creators. Surat al-Mu'minun, verses 12 and 14.
MashaAllah. So, if you would like, we can continue with bacteria, and how they are essential for the equilibrium in the on the earth, and even the food that we are eating, they are playing an important role. And bacteria are microorganisms that possess a great many features essential to life. They perform exceedingly important activities to maintain the equilibrium on earth. And bacteria supply countless vital elements, the air we breathe, the food that we are eating, and also the antibiotics that we are using. All of them are present thanks to the existence of bacteria, which are created by Allah. In fact, every bacterium is an expert chemist, and its laboratory is the nature. And as you talked about the enzymes, also the bacteria also are unconscious, but they are working like chemists. They are making conversion. I will explain how they are converting some material, some organic material to inorganic material, to let plants to use them. And for bacteria, reactions that even the cleverest chemists cannot solve are just child's play for bacteria. And for example, photosynthesis. This is one of their daily tasks. They perform it non-stop for billions of years. With photosynthesis, they break down carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and give off oxygen. So by this way, they meet life's most urgent need. They give us oxygen, and they also possess the ability to use light energy from the sun in order to separate carbon molecules from carbon dioxide. And the way that carbon obtained in this way represents the basis of Earth's carbon-based life forms. As we know, life is based on carbon, and all the basic organic molecules such as amino acids, proteins, and nucleic acids are formed by carbon atoms, and the atoms combine with other atoms. No other element in nature can replace carbon atom. This is there is no any similar atom which can replace carbon atom. This is necessary for life. So it proves even the existence of carbon atom proves the creation. There is no other choice for the life on Earth. So by photosynthesis, as we know, plants can make direct use of solar energy to turn out complex organic molecules. This transformation is necessary because human beings and animals can't make direct use of the sun's energy. They can obtain that energy only in synthesized form. In other words, as the result of the photosynthesis performed by green plants and microorganisms, they are necessary. For example, I want to give an example of bacterium, cyanobacteria. This bacterium produce approximately, in fact, more than a half of the oxygen in the atmosphere.
Yes.
This is very big amount.
Yes, and also some kind of evolutionists have some claims that somehow the primitive, so-called primitive bacteria find a way to produce, to get the understand that there is energy in the cell, and then get this energy to itself, and then somehow with so-called coincidences, it can produce energy and then the glucose and also oxygen and then do the photosynthesis and everything like that. And then produce these things for the needs of the plants and everything. But how could it be possible for a bacteria to understand that it can make these very complex systems?
Yes.
Because scientists, as you said, they don't understand how to make the photosynthesis right now.
They cannot imitate.
Yes, they cannot imitate it. They cannot use any kind of synthetic things to do it. They need the photosynthesis things, the enzymes and everything that the plants can do, chlorophylls and everything.
Yes.
And without it, they cannot do it.
Yes.
But somehow they say that by coincidences, bacteria can understand it, and by coincidences, again, so-called coincidences, it can happen. Of course, it is not true. Of course, it is clear that there is a pure creation here.
Mashallah.
We can understand it, inshallah.
And as we saw, only a single cell possess a system capable of providing such basic needs as food and oxygen, which are essential to human life, for human life. And there are countless chemical processes inside these processes, inside this one. And it is a part of ecological balance. This can never be explained by chance or by unconscious events. And Allah has specially created these living things to carry out this important process. Bacteria, they are saying this is not, they are saying so-called primitive for bacteria, but we see that they are making very important tasks. And nitrogen also is essential element to make proteins. We also need nitrogen, and bacteria also are working in this process. Although the air is approximately 80% nitrogen, most organisms cannot absorb it in this form. There should be a conversion. We can show the picture maybe. I will try to explain the nitrogen cycle. And we will see here on the screen now, yes. Atmospheric nitrogen returns to Earth in the form of nitric acid in rain as the result of phenomena such as lightning. Nitric acid is turned into nitrates by bacteria in the soil, and plants are able to absorb it in that form. So how they are doing this? Bacteria break down the waste products of animals and they produce ammonium compounds. They are, as we talked, like chemists. They are making conversion. They break down products and they produce ammonium compounds. And in the soil, there is very miraculous nitrifying bacteria. This is very important. These bacteria convert ammonium compounds to nitrates. And this is only the form of nitrogen which plant can absorb. How can a bacteria, should know? It has to change it to another form for the plants.
Yes, and also it shouldn't be so much complex
like
this. It can be so much more simple than we see it in here. But when we look at it, it is so much complex. There are so many steps, and you have just mentioned some of them right now. But in the middle, each bacteria, inside of each bacteria, thousands of proteins, thousands of processes occur. And each bacteria has a purpose. Each bacteria, each plant, each anything we eat, anything we do, just for the building blocks to produce to have nitrogen to produce our building blocks, the proteins.
Yes, and there is also another interesting thing. Between plants, which need nitrogen in order to grow, and the bacteria that meet that need, there's a very beneficial partnership. And some special bacteria called nitrogen-fixing bacteria. This is another bacteria which is important role in the nitrogen cycle. And this nitrogen-fixing bacteria can use nitrogen directly from the air. It can use it directly to make ammonium compounds. And in exchange for some nitrogen, these bacteria receive from the plants carbohydrates and special structures in roots, nodules, where they can exist in a moist environment. They find a moist environment. In exchange, they give to the plants nitrogen that they are in need. And so plants form a mutualistic symbiotic relationship with bacteria, nitrogen-fixing bacteria. This is special bacteria. And to complete the cycle, the nitrogen cycle is being completed now, other bacteria in the soil carry out a process known as denitrification. So by this way, this converts nitrates back to nitrogen gas to the atmosphere. This denitrifying, this process is now denitrifying. So this denitrifying bacteria break down nitrates back into nitrogen gas. So the cycle continues like this. There is an order in the universe, on the earth. Allah created special causes, like even the smallest creature, bacteria. And only a bacteria can change the form of the nitrogen just for the plants. However, Allah could create directly a nitrogen which is enough to plants, but there is not a simple process. Allah created a very complex process to show His might, mashallah.
Mashallah. And as you have discussed about the nitrogen cycle in the earth,
yes,
that this is the only process, this is the very important and the only process for us,
yes,
for all the people and all the animals, all the living things to continue their life. Without the nitrogen cycle, there won't be life. It is something very important, actually, because, mm-hmm, would you like, yes, to say something? Yes, and because this nitrogen cycle is very important. As you said, some bacteria know these chemical processes, and these bacteria can make it. And as a result, we continue our life normally all the time.
Yes. And also, I want to add something. Bacteria also has an important role in to produce foodstuff through fermentation. We know fermentation. Did you know that the yogurt and the cheese that we are eating are the work of bacteria? I didn't know before. But this is thanks to the bacteria that we can eat them, of course, by the creation of Allah. And all that the bacteria that produce cheese and yogurt really want is to obtain energy for carrying on with their lives. And for them, the closed environment in which they live is important because this species of bacteria breed without oxygen. Yeah, and yes.
Yeah. And while other bacteria obtain energy by breathing, this bacteria obtain energy by breaking down organic compounds around them. It is a miracle, mashallah.
Yes. By this way, they release many important substances. Mm. And these byproducts acidify the foodstuffs containing these bacteria, or else transform them into alcohol, or else bubbles of carbon dioxide are generated. And in this way, vegetables become pickled and sugars are transformed in a process known as fermentation. And during the fermentation process, bacteria release various minerals and synthesize very beneficial vitamins. How can it know which vitamin would be beneficial to the human? And that is why yogurt and cheese are so good for us. And it is also thanks to the bacteria that these products provide therapeutic effects on the intestines and a great many digestive disorders. And for example, the foods recommended for cholesterol problem are generally fermented one. And this is because there are important substances and minerals that is generated. And because that microorganisms, bacteria, are able to regulate the level of cholesterol in our bodies. MashaAllah, this is very important. There are several tasks they are doing. This is just a few of them. And behind the benefits imparted by bacteria is the obvious fact that Allah has created immaculate and a very different systems to let us see His evidence of creation. The way that everything happened by creation, and this is no chance for evolution to occur.
Inshallah. Yes, mashallah. And also, I want to talk now about something that the earth, there are so many miracles in the nature, and whenever we look through everything, we see the flawless creation. And Allah created them so beautiful and so perfect for us to see the manifestation of Allah in each of them. And as you said about the yogurt and the cheese, I have also read something about today, about the earth's layers. And there is a picture on the screen now I would like to show you. As you can see, this is the apple. And I just wonder if you have known that the place that we walk on, the ground, that we build our houses, that we open deep mines, is just as thin as this apple's peel when you compare it to the earth. When we look at the earth's structure, and here I will show you, this part, the one with the oceans and also with the lands, with the mountains and everything, it is just as thin as an eggshell or an apple peel. But and at the bottom, when you pass through this thin layer, there's something boiling.
Yes.
And under that, the inside of the earth is something with so hot, so much hot. It's a molten rock, but we don't feel it. We just feel the wind, for example, the chilling wind. And also we feel the cold snow, for example, it's snowing, we say that it is cold. Or we feel the fresh water, but we don't feel that hot. But in a minute I will mention about the degrees, how hot it is. And we never feel it. It is a blessing from Allah to us.
In the Quran verse, Allah mentions this, mashallah. I seek refuge in Allah from a curse of Satan. He possesses the power to send you punishment from above your heads or from beneath your feet. This is a miracle of Allah and also a warning from Him. And at the end of this verse, Allah says that, look how we vary the signs so that hopefully they will understand. It is it shows that we have to try to understand these signs from Allah.
Yes, and when we look at the structure of the earth, we can understand it easily. That inside it, really, it is melting.
Yes.
It is very hot. And the surrounding, the shell is very thin, so it means that it is very easy for that boiling hot substance to come out from that very thin ground. But it is not happening all the time. Only sometimes the volcanoes eruptions, and then we understand that this lava is coming out, and then makes even that is causes very so much disasters. But it's not happening so. Always. It's not happening always. It's a rare thing. And so it is very important to understand the earth and everything around it and everything written in the Quran, actually. It's very important to understand the things that we look around, the things that we should see as manifestations of Allah. And I would like you to see the picture again to continue. As you can see, the outer part is called the crust. And it has two parts, two regions. One of them is the oceans, the other one is the lands. They call it oceanic crust and the continental crust because, as you can see, it is very thin. And the, under that, as we said, it is a there is a hot and dense rock called the mantle. And the mantle, now I will show you on the screen also. Yes, now here. The mantle consists of hot, molten, silicate rock containing iron and magnesium. Why I'm saying this? Because it is important. The things that it contains is very important. Silicium is something that gives this molten structure to this rock. It is like asphalt, as maybe people might know. It is not like water, but it is liquid, some kind of viscous.
Intense.
Yes, intense. And it is something like a black sea, maybe you can imagine, because it is the nearly 84% of the earth it contains, the earth structure. It means it is very thick,
yes.
But it is melting. And as a result of the minerals, as a result of the temperature is very high. Actually now it is amazing that 500 centigrade degrees near the crust and nearly 4,000 centigrade degrees near to the core.
4,000?
It has, yes. It has three regions and on the very top it is a little bit cooler. And when it goes down to the core, it gets hotter. And also, it is not the only thing that it is hot, it is also the pressure. There is so much pressure in there. And as we can see, it is something very, the pressure in there, actually I have read today and it is really amazing. Because at the sea level, for the scientists, they accept it as the one atmospheric pressure at the sea level. But in the mantle, the pressure is 1.4 million atmospheric pressure.
1.4 million.
Yes. And for us, that we can survive, it is one atmospheric pressure in the sea level. It is something normal for us. And as we can see, I would like to show you a video about how mantle looks like. The mantle is something that moves. It is, as we said, it is viscous, not solid, but also like asphalt, not like sea, not so much liquid. But it is moving. How it is moving? The ones at the top are cooler, the ones at the bottom, close to the core, are hotter. So there is a circle happening. They are always circling. As a result of this, the circle, it makes the ground, the crust, move. And as a result of these movements, the crusts come together and then the mountains occur. And there are some hot spots that cause the volcanoes to erupt. And tectonic plates are occur because of these movements. This is something very special actually, that all the continents, continentals, are moving because of the movement of the mantle. And now I will show you the video. Now you can see in here, as this is the mantle, you see, and the hot part is coming to the top all the time, moving like this, making a circle in here and in here, and it causes the movement of the crust. Yes, the ground, the normal ground. As a result, it causes the, now you will see them, one part will get on the top of the other part, and as a result, yes, you can see the movement of the mantle. Now this is the Earth's continentals. And now you will see how, as you can see in here, as this one, this part is moving downward, it's getting hot. And, sorry, and as it gets hot, because this is rock, this is something cold on the ground, snowing, everything. But when it gets here, this part is too hot. As we said, thousands of degrees. Then it becomes melting and then runs to the surface. And then as a carbon dioxide or the gases or something else, we see it as the volcano. But actually, as you can see the lava here, there is something very deep down there that's getting, there's so much business down there. As you can see, and this is something very miraculous, mashallah. And yes, we can continue. As we said, this is the mantle. And next one is the outer core. Now we reach to the outer core. It's getting hotter for the outer core. Temperature is 4,000 degrees. And outer core is the yellow part in here. And outer core is also very miraculous because in this part, the magnetic field of the earth is 50 times more than the surface. When they look at this part, if this part was not exist, then the earth's magnetic field would never be happen. And we would never survive without this part of the earth. And this is liquid. again. This contains iron and nickel, some alloys. But this part is, I would like to show you the, yes, you see the, this is like a spot, you know, this is the earth and this is the sun. And the solar winds are coming to the sun, this is coming through the sun to our earth. And as a result of that small outer core, you can see something like so big and blue in here. This is our shield, the earth's shield against the sun, sun's solar winds. And in here, this part, the you can see here, the outer core is 3,000 kilometers away from the surface. This distance is 3,000 kilometers. And in here, the temperature is again very high, and again pressure is so high. But when we continue with the inner core, this is the center. Inner core, now the temperature is 5,000 or 6,000 degrees Celsius. This is something close to sun.
Yes.
And it is so much iron in here. But this time, this part is not liquid because there is so much pressure. And this pressure is so much that 3 million times than the air pressure. This time, the atmospheric...
3 million times.
Yes. Atmospheric pressure. And also there was information about it that they say that if someone could be able to travel to the center of the earth, to the core, then he would be squeezed into the size of a ball, like smaller than a marble, because of that pressure.
Yes.
This is something very amazing. And it is this 6,000 kilometers away from the surface of the, surface of the Earth. And actually, I would like to show something else. Yes, as we said, we have counted actually totally 7 layers. As we said, these are the crusts, oceanic, continental, and then the 3 parts of the mantle, these are. One of them is the astenosphere, upper mantle, lower mantle. These are the different as a result of the temperature, pressure, and mineral amounts. But as we said, it is always circling. And then outer core and inner core. And this is a miracle of Quran. And in the Quran, also Allah says, I seek refuge with Allah from the accursed Satan. I would like to show you also the verse. It is Allah who created the 7 heavens and of the earth the same number. As it is said, 7 as the earth's layers. The command descending down through all of them, so that you might know that Allah has power over all things and that Allah encompasses all things in His knowledge. Surat At-Talaq, verse 12. And in here, we can easily understand that there is an amount, there is a balance, there is a delicate balance. And these can never happen by coincidence, because if this is was happening with coincidence, from everywhere there should be some kind of boiling hot material coming out to the surface and turning our life into disaster. But it is not happening.
And we could also sense this pressure, this temperature. We have talked about some extreme temperature and pressures which exist in the earth, but we never sense them. This is the mercy of Allah, who protects us every second, and we never feel this pressure. You said a very big pressure, 3 million times of when
normal
we compare
one.
Compared to the Earth, and another layer it was 1.4 million. This is very big number, and we never feel this pressure. We could never survive in such conditions.
Yes, of course. And it is something that we should think deeply. Allah show us that Allah can create such conditions, but protect us against them. And the earth, the conditions of the earth, because we all the body parts and everything, living things, contain carbon. And maybe you might remember carbon is something that cannot be work with very high temperatures or very low temperatures, only with the conditions of the earth. With the seasons, summer, winter, at these conditions, our Earth's temperature never rises so much high or never goes down so much low. Always there is a balance, and always there is normal conditions for us to survive. for the living things to survive. And but this is a blessing. Awesome. Everybody should think deeply about it. This is a blessing from Allah for us.
And also, actually, this order on Earth is the result of the Big Bang. When we think about this, it is a miracle. Mashallah. Big Bang is an explosion, and after this explosion, actually, it is the disorder.
Yes.
From this disorder, Allah created the order on Earth.
Perfect.
Only, yes, the perfect order.
Mashallah.
Only the power of Allah can create this kind of an order from disorder. We know that Big Bang is the starting point, mm-hmm. and from this starting point, from this explosion, now we are living on Earth without even understanding, feeling this kinds of miraculous process in the core of the Earth.
Yes.
And this is a miracle of Allah for us. And in one of the Quran verses, Allah says that, I seek refuge in Allah from a curse Satan. He who created the seven heavens in the layers, you mm-hmm. will not find any flaw in the creation of all merciful. And do you see any gaps? Allah asks to us. And on the end of the verse, Allah says that, then look again and again, you will see that you will return to you dazed and exhausted, because
you will never find any
flaw in the creation of Allah. Never you can find with these kinds of things, inshallah.
And as we talked, there are miracle in creation, and also you talked, both of you, miracle of the Quran.
Yes.
And this show how can a man could know about seven layers of the atmosphere or on the earth or Big Bang. Everything is written in the Quran before 14 centuries ago. And you can find all the miracles of the Quran on website of Harun Yahya, which is miraclesoftheQuran.com. Inshallah.
Inshallah. And now, for now, we will have a short break, mm-hmm. and then we will continue. Selamun Aleyküm, dear brothers and sisters. We will continue with the end times and Hazrat Mehdi. And first of all, we would like to, and miracles of the Quran. First of all, we would like to introduce one of the Mr. Adnan Oktar's books,
The Glad Tidings of the Messiah.
Yes. We know that the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, second coming is a very important and great gift for all of us, for all humanity. And for the first time ever in their lives, all people alive at that time will see a prophet of superior human qualities. And while reading this book of Mr. Adnan Oktar, the reader will come to know of the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, miraculous life, and realize that we live in a very special time. And given that his second coming will be an extraordinary, miraculous, and metaphysical event that will affect the whole world, all believers should prepare and mobilize to welcome him in the best possible way. And all of the signs indicate that the second coming will take place soon, so there is no time to waste. And our sisters and our brothers can acquire this Full of Wisdom book from the official bookstore of Harun Yahya. It is www.bookglobal.net.
Inshallah. And if you like, we can continue with the miracle of the Quran. With a historical miracle of the Quran. And as you know, Haman is a character whose name is mentioned in the Quran along with the Pharaoh. And he is mentioned in six different places in the Quran. He was one of the Pharaoh's closest allies. And surprisingly, the name Haman is never mentioned in those sections of the Torah pertaining to the life of Prophet Moses. And approximately 200 years ago, the Egyptian hieroglyph script had been deciphered, and the name Haman has been discovered in ancient scripts. And until the 18th century, the writings and inscriptions of the ancient Egypt could not be understood because the writings is not comprehensible. The ancient Egyptian writing system consisted of hieroglyphs and stylized pictures, not an alphabet that we are not using. This was very difficult, and nobody could understand it until 18th century, and also it has been forgotten because nobody used this hieroglyphs, and we can show a picture which is taken in 1799. This is Rosetta Stone. The mystery of ancient Egyptian hieroglyphs was solved by the discovery of this tablet. This is called Rosetta Stone. And this tablet dates back to 196 before Christ. Through the decoding of hieroglyph, an important piece of knowledge was revealed. Thanks to this discovery, the name Haman was indeed mentioned in Egyptian inscriptions, like in the Quran, in the same way, in fact. And the same inscription also indicated the close relationships between Haman and the pharaoh. And in the Dictionary of People in the New Kingdom, which was prepared based on the entire collection of inscriptions, Haman is said to be the head of stone quarry workers. Now let's see the verse of the Quran. Let me read the verse of the Quran. And in the Quran, Allah describes the event where the Pharaoh asked Haman to build a tower, as we know, and this is in perfect agreement with these archaeological findings. The fact that Haman is the head of stone quarry workers. And I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Pharaoh said, "Counsel, I do not know of any other deity for you apart from me. Haman, kindle a fire for me over the clay and build me a lofty tower so that perhaps I may be able to climb up to Moses' deity. I consider him a blatant liar." Surat Al-Qasas, verse 38. And the discovery of the name Haman on ancient Egyptian inscriptions once again revealed that the Quran was sent down from the sight of God. This is the word of Allah. Nobody could know this fact. Even in the Old Testament, in the Torah, it is not mentioned in the section about the life of Prophet Moses. And in a miraculous way, the Quran conveys to us historical information that could not have been possessed or understood at the time of the Prophet Muhammad, mashallah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Inshallah. Yes. And also, as you have mentioned about the miracle of Quran, about the times of Prophet Moses, and also there is something that I would like to say again. This is a miracle of Quran, and the word Pharaoh has been stated in the Quran, but also the word Pharaoh has been stated in the Old Testament about the Egyptian rulers during the time of Hazrat Prophet Abraham and Prophet Joseph. Mm-hmm. But however, this title was actually employed after their time.
Yes.
And at that time, for the Egyptian rulers, they were saying the word Al-Malik in the Quran. It's stated like this. It refers to a ruler, a king. And in a verse, "I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan," the king said, "Bring him to me straight away." The king. This is the word that is used in the Quran. But for the Old Testament, they said the name Pharaoh. But for the rulers, only for the Quran, when we look at the Quran, we see that for the rulers in the Prophet Moses' time, the name of the ruler is the Pharaoh at that time. And in distinction to the Quran, not in the Old Testament or in the Jewish any kind of informations, it is not like this. But it is, of course, we know that the Quran is far more concise and accurate about these facts. The use of the word Pharaoh in Egyptian history belongs to only the late period.
Yes.
This is something scientific they have discovered. This particular title, this name Pharaoh, the word Pharaoh, began to be employed in the 14th century before Christ. And during the region of the Amotep, the fort, and the Prophet Joseph lived 200 years before that.
Yes.
So it means that the name could not be used at the time of Prophet Joseph. And in the Encyclopedia Britannica, It says that the word pharaoh was a title of respect used for the new kingdom and after the prophet Joseph. Mm-hmm. And also it is between the 18th Dean's Day and the 22nd Dean's Day. It is called like mm-hmm. this, the period of times. Mm-hmm. And it addresses the title of the king at that time, the pharaoh. And for further information, Academic American Encyclopedia also, they have give more information mm-hmm. that the pharaoh name, the word pharaoh for the ruler, has begun to be used in the new kingdom. And in the verse, I seek refuge in Allah from the curse of Satan. In this way, we gave you news of what has gone before. And we have give you a reminder direct from us. Those who turn away from it will bear a heavy burden on the day of rising. And as we have seen, the use of the word pharaoh dates from a specific period yes. in time. And this period is very important, that the period of Prophet Moses.
And at that this time. Is a miracle.
Yes, and also yes. as you have stated, the pharaoh and Haman yes. at their time. The things are happening and also the verses are stating at that period of time.
Yeah.
MashaAllah.
And this is not the only a miracle of the Quran about the pharaoh. Also Allah mentions that he will preserve the body of the pharaoh in yes. the Quran. We know that pharaoh is the ruler with the, and he and his court were devoted to their polytheistic system. Yes. And also idolatrous beliefs there were involved. And indeed, according to their beliefs, pharaoh was actually a deity himself, and at this time Allah sent Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, as his messenger to the people of the Egypt. But Pharaoh, however, responded to the calls of Prophet Moses, peace be upon him, with the threats and also with the slanders. And this arrogant attitude lasted until he faced Allah's punishment. Mm-hmm. And when he was faced, that we know that, with the threat of death through the drowning. And Allah mentions this position of the mm-hmm. pharaoh who turned to faith, and he says that pharaoh turned to faith at just that moment. And mm-hmm. this is described in the Quran. In the verses, I seek refuge in Allah from a curse of Satan. We brought the tribe of Israel across the sea, and Pharaoh and his troops pursued them out of tyranny and enmity. Then he was on the point of drowning. Pharaoh said, I believe that there is no deity but him in whom the tribe of Israel believes. I am one of the Muslims. At Surah Yunus, verse 19. But however, this last-minute conversion was not accepted yes. by Allah. And also this was revealed in the Quran. I seek refuge in Allah from a curse of Satan. What? Now? When? Previously you rebelled and were one of the corruptors. Today we will preserve your body so you can be a sign for people who come after you. Surely many people are heedless of our signs. Surah Yunus, verse 91 and 92. And the information of the Pharaoh's corpse when it would serve as a sign for later generations may be regarded as an indication that this body would not decay, but on display in the royal mummy's chamber of the Egyptian Museum in Cairo, in the body of Pharaoh, it is actually displayed, and just was this information just revealed as like 14 centuries ago. Mm-hmm. And we know that these miracles, of course, signs for us to understand the power of Allah and also the creation and the information of Allah about everything in detail. And these signs also shows that Quran is enough for us. Muslims believes in Quran, and every detail is enough for us to understand everything in our lives. And the Hippocrates, but Mr. Adnan Oktar once said that in his interviews, for Muslims, yes, Quran is enough, but for the Hippocrates, the Quran is not enough. They are always trying to find another things. They have a religion in their minds, but they cannot find this religion in the Quran. But Allah, Mr. Adnan, sorry, Mr. Adnan Oktar said that the Muslims knows that the in the search religion in the Quran and knows that this religion is enough for that because this it is from the Allah. Alhamdulillah, it is a very important point. So these miracles and to learn these miracles is very important for us. Also to tell these important points for the other people who does not have any information about the Quran and the religion about Islam. Because many people right now doesn't know the true Islam. The true Islam is the one that Allah revealed us in the Quran 14 centuries ago.
And also, as you have mentioned about the miracles of Quran and the hypocrites' behaviors, according to this this thing, but also this time it is very important as we are in the end times. It is also something very miraculous that Hazrat Mehdi has come, Jesus peace be upon him has come. Yes, they have already come. But we don't know where they are and who they are, but we will see them. We are just seeing their influence all around the earth. And but this is very important that even though the hypocrites don't want to see the Hazrat Mehdi, this is in the destiny. So it will happen. And also the Golden Age will happen. Islamic Union will happen, Turkish Islamic Union will happen, and there will be peace in all around the world. But it is very important, as Mr. Adnan Oktar all the time tries to explain, that Muslims will have a leader. In every time Muslims have leaders, they had leaders, and now again they will have a leader. And this leader will be the Hazrat Mehdi.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. And there's a video about him.
And before the video, I want to add something. Also, Mr. Adnan Oktar said that right now we say that inshallah Hazrat Mehdi alayhi salam emerged, actually is on charge, but we don't know, we didn't see him yet. But and also Hazreti Jesus peace be upon him inshallah came. We hope that inshallah. Maybe we didn't see them yet, but Mr. Adnan Oktar said that the people on earth will start to feel the warm, and this but they will not understand that they are getting warmer just because of these people. This is the these of course holy people inshallah. This is because they are signs, and these signs are occurring one by one, and after these signs Allah will make them emerge, but maybe they will not right now understand that they are on work, but inshallah
we will see
that at the point, at the end of the point.
Inshallah. And now we can show the video.
Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam insanların imanlarına vesile olacak, ancak kalp gözleri kör olanlar Kur'an ahlakından uzak duracağını Peygamber Efendimiz bildirmiş. Şöyle söylüyor, buyuruyor. Bir kişi kör olup ondan yararlanmasa bile Hazretleri, Hazreti Mehdi Aleyhisselam bir güneş gibi herkese fayda sağlar.
Efendim, Mehdi deyince insan hep illaki kafa bir tek şahsı takıyor. Çünkü Mehdiyet demek Kur'an'ın bütününde ısrarla anlatılan, sana demin yani Allah bize vurguyla anlatılan İslam'ın dünya hakimiyetine vesile olan kişi demektir. Kişi ve kişiler. Ama başsız hiçbir toplumdan bahsetmiyor Kur'an'da. Yani her toplumun mutlaka başı var. Mesela Firavun devrinde Firavun adamların başı. Müslümanların liderinde nasip ederse de başsız değil de şahsı manevi idare etmiyor. Müslümanlar mezhepler ayırmamıştı mesela. Hazreti Musa'nın kalktığında mezhep ayırmaya kalkarlarsa Hazreti Musa hemen onu ortadan kaldırıyor. Tek topluluk olmasını istiyor. Ama küfür de kabul ediyor. Firavun da sadece benim görüşüm hakim olacak diyor. Benim dinim hakim olacak diyor. Yani dolayısıyla iki görüş sürekli çatışma halleri. Mehdiyet'te de cahil. Hiçbir devirde ara verilmemiştir. Her devirde mesela Nemrut devrinde Hazreti İbrahim Müslümanlar lideri. ne Celiyet'i Nemrut temsil ediyor. Nemrut başka fikri kabul etmiyor. Kendi düşüncesini kabul ediyor. Buhtun asır devrinde de öyle. Her devirde öyledir.
Yes, hypocrites are against Islamic Union. They don't want to Islam prevail the world, and they don't want the Mehdi as leader because they are arrogant and they think that they know the best, and they never strive on Allah's path, and they are terrified of both Islamic moral values prevailing and the emergence of Islamic Union, because if there is an Islamic Union, they know that Mehdi will lead this Islamic Union, and they are they don't want this. There is a paradox here. If one is real Muslim, he would want as soon as possible the establishment of Islamic Union, because in every part of the world, Muslims are suffered, they are massacred, and if there would be an Islamic Union, if the Mehdi would be in on the charge, and nobody could do this, nobody could make such damages, could suffer Muslims, innocent Muslims. And there's a verse in which Allah tells us about hypocrites and how they are opposed to Islamic Union, to jihad, which means intellectual struggle, of course. I want to read the verse. It is Surat An-Nisa, verse 77. I seek refuge in Allah from the accursed Satan. Do you not see those who were told, hold back from fighting, but establish salat and pay alms? Then when fighting is prescribed for them, a group of them fear people as Allah should be feared, or even more than that. They say, our Lord, why have you prescribed fighting for us? If only you would give us just a little more time. We see they are very, they are scared of the people in the world, not Allah. They don't fear Allah. Say, the enjoyment of the world is very brief. The hereafter is better for those who have fear of Allah. You will not be wronged by so much as the smallest speck. MashaAllah, they are doing everything. Yeah. When you look from outside, you see they are making, they are fasting, they are praying salat, they are performing salat, and they always pray, as we see. But when the time comes to struggle, intellectual struggle against Darwinism, materialism, other atheist philosophies, they don't prefer it. They say, I'm happy at my home, I will fast, I will pray, it is enough for me. But it is not so. Allah ordered us to struggle against the people who suffer Muslims, for the people who need help, who demand help from Allah to live easily.
Yes.
And if the video is ready, we can show the excerpt of Mr. Harun Yahya about hypocrites, how they seek to complicate the religion.
Yes.
Inshallah.
Esastır diyor dinler. peygamber böyle olur diyorlar. Haşa. Nasıl bir diyorlarsa anlat bize diyor. İşte detay veriyor Hazreti Musa, Cenab-ı Allah diyor. Olmadı diyorlar. Yani bu detay yeterli değil. Daha da detaylandır bize diyorlar. Allah diyor, neredeyse kesmeyecek. Evet. Diyor. Şimdi zaten istemiyorlar. İşte, onun için münafık kafası böyle katman karışık insandır. İnsan. Akıl almaz detayları bulur. Mehdiyet aklında da sade ve keskin akıl. Hüküm sürer. Maşallah. Hikmet hüküm sürer. Münafık da demagoji ve mantık. Mehdi'de de akıl ve hikmet esastır. Mehdi'de kolaylaştırmak ve sadeleştirmek esastır. Deccaliyette ve münafık şeytani sistemde de karmaşık hale getirip boğmak esastır ve zorlaştırmak esastır. Onun için münafık sistem alabildiğine zorlaştırarak Müslümanlığı içinden çıkılmaz bir haşa böyle şeytani bataklığa çevirmeye çalışır. Yani Müslümanlıktan çıkartır olayı. Bir şeytani bataklığa çevirir. Ve Müslümanı bunun için de boğar. Mesela namaz kılacaksa kılamayacak hale getirir. Bir bakar adam, yani tarif edilen namaz kılınacak gibi kılamaz. Mesela tarif edilen abdeste bakar, alamaz o abdesti. Tarif edilen hayata bakar, o hayatta yaşayacak gibi değil. Çünkü akıl ve ruh sağlığını bozan bir sistemden başlıyor. Bak, hem beden sağlığını, hem akıl ve ruh sağlığını, hem sosyal sağlığı, toplum sağlığının tamamını bozan bir sistemdir. Buna fakir. Mehdi'nin sisteminde ise bereket, bolluk, zindelik, canlılık, aktivite var. Çünkü hikmet ve özlü bilgi vardı. Mesela bak diyor ki, Zülkarneyn kısasında özü kapsayan bir bilgi diyor. Münafıkta özü kapsayan bilgi olmaz. Çetrefil bilgi olur. Karma karışıktır. Kargacık burgacıktır münafıkta. Ama mehdiyette özü kapsayan bilgi var. Öz. Az ve öz. Hikmet. Münafık karmaşıklığıyla da zorluklara girmesine dönüyor. Çünkü karmaşık ve zorluklara gelecek ki hem mehdiyeti kaldırabilsin, hem İslamiyet'in gelişmesini durdurabilsin, hem kendi sistemini devam ettirebilsin. Çünkü karma karışık ve zor bir İslamiyet belli ki yaşanmayacaktır. Belli ki kendi içinde yıkılacaktır. Yıkılınca da münafığın hayatı en yüksek seviyeye çıkacaktır. Kendine göre. İstediği gibi ahlaksızlığını yapacaktır. Çünkü diyecek ki Müslümanlık kalmamış zaten. Kimse yaşayamıyor. Dolayısıyla ben de yaşamıyorum. Kendilerine benzetmek isterler diyorlar. Ay,
evet.
Şimdi kendine benzetmek için ne yapacak münafık? Dini güzel mi gösterecek? Kolay mı gösterecek? Aklını rahatça kavrayacak gibi delillerle mi anlatacak? Münafığın en çekindiği bu. Münafık ne yapar biliyor musun dinden güzelmek için? Dini içinden çıkılmayacak hale getirir. Yaşanmayacak hale getirir. Buyurun size dinler. Hadi yaşayın. Bak ben yaşıyorum der. Adam yaşayamaz, bak ben senden üstünüm der. Ama bak gördün der, din yaşanamayacağım, yaşanamayan bir sistem der. En sonunda. Yani şeytanın yaptığı da budur.
İnşallah.
Bak diyor, önlerinden, arkalarından, sağlarından, sollarından yaklaşacağım derken, detayı kastediyor. Akıl almaz detaylara boğacağım onları diyor. Mesela sırf namazda bile detay yüzünden namaz kılamayan binlerce insan var. İnşallah. Şeytanın oyununa gelmiştir. Mesela kıraat yanlış yaptığını düşünün namazın. O yüzden namazını kılmaz. Mesela abdeste vesvese yapar. Yani şeytani bir detay içerisine girer. O detayları yapamadığını düşündüğü için de namazını kılmaz. Hatta diyor ki kalbim diyor namazda tam olarak Allah'a teksif olmuyor. Diyor. Zaman zaman kafama vesveseler geliyor. Ben bu yüzden namaz kılıyorum diyen ben çok fazla insan tanıdım. Bak şeytan detayla onu boğuyor. Onun için münafıklar bunu çok iyi keşfetmiştir. Detayı. Detayda Müslümanlar boğmak isterler. Böyle ahmaktır. Gece gündüz onlarla uğraşırlar. Hangi detayda Müslümanları boğabiliriz acaba kimsinde? Mehdi hep de onları boğar. Maşallah.
Yes. And we have a book which is title is The Prophet Jesus Aleyhisselam and Hazret Mehdi Aleyhisselam Will Come This Century. let's read a hadith about this subject. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, people will gather around Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam in the year 1400. This is Risalet al-Kuruj al-Mehdi. And as we know, the subject of Mehdi is one that has always occupied an important place in the Islamic world ever since the age of bliss. And hoping that Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam will be instrumental in making the afflictions Muslims have been going through, the intellectual systems based on denial, to come to an end, believers have always awaited the coming of this blessed individual, and they always prayed to Allah for it to come about. And the hadiths of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speak of Muslims eagerly awaiting the coming of Prophet Jesus alaihi wasallam and Hazreti Mehdi alaihi wasallam. And in this book there are several important information, and we learned from this book Hazreti Mehdi alaihi wasallam will never shed blood, and he will fill the earth with justice, which was previously filled with oppression and violence. And in the hadiths, he says, our Prophet, whoever of you lives to see him, let him crawl over snow to him and join him, because he is Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam. And in this book, there are physical features of Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam, the appearance of time and the lifespan of this world, and also the signs of the appearance of Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam, which are the signs of end times as we are living now. He will appear in Turkey, in Istanbul. He will appear with holy relics, and he will have some spiritual features also, which are very significant. And the hypocrites in his time, and the so-called religious scholars which will live in his time, in Hijra 1400, and other important information. You can download this book or book or purchase from bookglobal.net.
Yes, inshallah. Also, and chief of staff of Iran's armed forces, Major General Said Hassan, yes, Firozobadi, is he got this book from some of our friends, and I would like to show a video about his appreciation of the book.
The representative of Harun Yahya were invited to this conference in Iran.
Yes. This is the same book that we have presented.
Yes, yes.
And now our friend is explaining about the book. MashaAllah.
We like very much.
This is in a conference about Hazrat Mehdi alayhi.
This is the International Conference of Mehdiism Doctrine, the 7th of which was organized in Iran between the 14th and the 15th of July 2011. He is close to Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, and we will see how he will pray for the imminent emergence of Hazreti Mehdi aleyhisselam.
MashaAllah. And also, yes, we have a cute kitten video. Now I would like to show you. As you can see here. As you can see, so cute, MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.
Yes, the name is Cricket. So defenseless.
Yes.
And
needs love.
Yes, MashaAllah. So cute, so sweet. How could it be possible? When you look at also the colors of its
fur.
Yes, fur, its fur. You see that they are also, they have a symmetry. Sorry. As you can see, they have a color, they have a pattern.
Yes, which are symmetrical.
Yes. They are very beautiful. How could it be possible that it is it coming just by the coincidence? How could it be possible?
It has like a makeup in inside.
MashaAllah.
MashaAllah.
Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also liked very much cats.
Yes. MashaAllah. MashaAllah. So sweet. And I would like to show a website. Yes, awaitedmehdi.com. Sisters and brothers may get more information from this website about Hazrat Mehdi and also hadiths.
Yes.
And also some very important scholars' tellings about Hazrat Mehdi.
Risale-i Nur
collections. And also the coming of the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him.
And the books about.
And you can see the details now. And the book that we have
introduced. Documentaries, everything.
Yes. There are so many very important information about Hazrat Mehdi in here.
And you can share this website on your web page, on Facebook.
Yes.
You should share it.
Yes. And we said that some of the people doesn't want the establishment of the Turkish Islamic Union, but it is like they do not want the stop of this shedding blood. It
same
is the
thing.
Same thing, actually. And also some of these people trying to show that the Islamic Union is a bad thing. But actually, maybe they are not aware of them. Maybe some of them are aware, sorry. And this is actually the property of Dajjal and Antichrist. Because in one of the hadiths of our Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that Dajjal will show the fire as water and will show the water as fire. He will label the opposite. But inshallah, Hazrat Mehdi alayhi salam will show us the fire as fire and the water as water. He will label everything as they are. And inshallah, all the Muslims, and not actually the Muslims, all the mankind will live with peace that we are looking for hundreds of thousands of years. Inshallah.
There's two ways. If you support Islamic Union,
yes,
or otherwise you support Antichrist.
Yes.
Yes. And for tonight, we have come to the end of our speak. Tomorrow at GMT plus 2 at 2:30, we will be together at the channel A9. And until then, selamun aleyküm and have a nice day.